Beloved, I'm so excited about this word. On the triumph of faith, made the cripple walk, made the weakling walk strong. Now, we have so many examples as we continue in this study. I'm so excited about it because I can just see the Holy Spirit directing me and speaking to me even I haven't gotten to those texts. Isn't that an exciting thing that you can win? You can actually rise by faith. It's discouraging, but you can rise. It's distressing, but you can rise. It's perplexing, but you can rise. It's the triumph of faith over this world, over Satan, over everything that's coming against you. Once again, 1 John 4:4, for whatsoever is born of God overcometh the world. And this is the victory, in case you have it confused. This is the victory that overcometh the world, even our faith. Why didn't the Bible say even your faith? He says our faith. This is why Satan has been so successful, that believers have not recognized that it's as we band together in faith. A collective faith dynamic is what torpedoes the principalities arrayed against us. And we defeat them when we are joined together. I've pointed out many times that as much as God was moving in the early church, but the only times you saw major moving and quaking of God's glory and power was when they banded together as one. God worked miracles individually, but the building shook. The earth trembled. Earthquakes happen. Pentecost, the atmosphere, the Holy Spirit came down and changed the atmosphere on earth, and it has not remained the same. And even though you and I are engaged in some fierce battles, that's why God gave me this message. We're involved in fierce battles, and we are trying to hold on. But don't hold on in your emotions, hold on in your faith. And then let your faith and my faith connect. And let our faith produce that overcoming breakthrough, overcoming anointed, overcoming charge, overcoming force. Hallelujah. Let's triumph by our faith, joining together as one. And God answering us with power and strength in Jesus' name. Glory to God. Listen to this. Who is he that overcometh the world but he that believeth that Jesus is the Son of God? Is there any doubt then, while there's such an onslaught against the word of God in our time? Is there any doubt then, beloved? Why everybody's trying to convince you that Jesus is just a prophet and that he's not the Son of God and the only way to God? Is it surprising to you that there's this move towards accommodation? And if you take any stand against anything, you are branded a hater and all kinds of venom is thrown at you. May God strengthen you where you stand. Who is he that overcometh the world? First he says, if you're born of God, whatever is born of God overcomes. Then he tells you what the victory is, our faith. Now he tells you who will get this benefit. If you believe that Jesus is the Son of God, and you will not negotiate it. Now somebody will sit there and say, well, I believe that. Let's check out your belief then. How do you know you believe this? It's when you are challenged, when life is pressing against you, and you put your faith in the Lord Jesus. You see him as the only answer. You don't have empirically or didactically or sequentially what the steps are to solve your problem. But you believe that Jesus is the Son of God. He says the seed of God in you even though it doesn't quite say it that way, but he says in another place in this same book, the seed of God in you prevents you from sinning and will give you this victory. I've given testimonies of God healing me of cancer, God doing, you know, different things in my life. I've gone through so much in this life, beloved. But many times I despaired. But God still came and resurrected me. That's why he gave me this ministry called Resurrection House for All Nations. It's for people that have been raised from their death. You've lost all hope. You don't see how to go forward. You don't know when. You just want, sometimes you want to even kill yourself, for some of you. This bud's for you. This word is for you. You will still triumph if you believe that Jesus is the Son of God and that you receive the answer and you're not looking for anybody else or anything else. That's the miracle of what I'm preaching. You are settled. I love that old song. My hope is built on nothing less than Jesus' blood and righteousness. You see? Nothing else. Then there's the second part that I don't quite remember. On Christ, the solid rock I stand. All other ground is shifting sand. All other ground is shifting sand. Hallelujah. Glory to God. That's what he has given to us. That's where we stand against every satanic weapon of sickness, disease, lust, pride, fear, hatred, prejudice, nepotism, discrimination. But let me add, discrimination does not include correcting people in their sin. I'm not discriminating against you because I'm telling you what you're doing is wrong. I don't know why it's only in the gay and lesbian situation that we see discrimination. No, that we correct them as we correct us heterosexuals. When we engage in sin, we are wrong. Just as everybody's wrong. If you lie, you're wrong. If you cheat, you're wrong. The gospel must be preached, and it's not hate speech, beloved. Receive the word of God, and may you go from total defeat to total triumph by your faith in Jesus' name. Amen. We love you. We'll conclude tomorrow. Bye-bye.